Okay, so here we go. Since I have been away, some of the things that I do want to discuss is about ninjas and business. Ninjas in business. If you don't know what a ninja is, you know, like the scent with all black, and they come and disappear, and then they come back again, and they hit you with a karate chop, and then they run out, and then they do something else with a samurai sword or something. A samurai, but still, they come in and they come out and walk off. Okay, whatever. Black people, y'all are janky when it comes to business. And I was talking to my girl Dia, and I said, you know what, I really need to get back into business consulting, because damn it, man, damn it. When people are doing business, do it the right way. Always find yourself a paper trail, because you don't want to end up like how I did last year, where I lost a lot of money. To me, if I lose a dollar, that's losing a lot of money, but it was more than a dollar. And it was stupid on my part. And I, even with following with papers and contract, some people are still a little bit shady and janky. Now, not gonna go into details with the what happened, but there's, it was just crazy. Last year it was crazy. So I want to tell you guys to be confident in what you do, for one. But don't just go by phone conversations. For two, phone conversations are the life and death of any business, because there's nobody there to back up the conversation, especially if it's not recorded. If you do decide to record it, utilize a recording system that both are aware of, like a conference number. They have a couple of conference numbers that you can call and record, and it can always be playback. Once the conversation is done, I always tend to download it. But I do warn them that this call is going to be recorded for business purposes, etc., etc., so forth and so on. And you keep it in your file. Excuse me. And if they request, well, or say, I never did say that. Well, do you remember the phone conversation we had on the conference call? Let me send you a copy of it so that you are aware. A lot of people don't believe in getting attorneys. Janky ninjas. If you're too cheap to even get a consultation, sometimes, which is free, and you want to have a business, why are you in business? What are you doing? Make sure you have some source, not your mama them, not your auntie and them, not a cousin who's been to college for 2 years, who wanted to be an attorney, but all he took was general ed classes. No, that's not gonna work. If you're too cheap, get prepaid legal. That's an entrepreneur's best friend. What is it, like $20 a month? How difficult is $20 a month to pay? And you could call an attorney and ask him about contracts, and he could either tell you yes or no to an extent. However, you have that to back you up, and a representation if you need to go to court. Contracts are definitely your best friend. Keep a contract with whatever you do, because somebody will play you and will act like there is nothing that ever happened. They will. Been there. And make sure they're signed and returned. You get two copies. You make one copy for yourself. Actually, you keep the original and you send them back a copy so that both of you all have it on file. The other thing is, and if they don't have it, you also have a PDF. Sometimes I will send my PDF where it's an electronic signature that can be used in court. Paper trail, emails, inboxes, text messages. I always find it interesting when there's people who are calling me and we're having a conversation. They have all the questions, but yet after the conversation is done, they don't remember anything that was said, except for maybe two things. How was your day? And when will I get paid? That's all they'll remember. So it's very important to have a paper trail with whatever you do in business. Again, via inbox, via email, via your cell phone, text messages. They can be used in court if need be. I don't always like to think about the negative when it comes to business, but sometimes y'all ninjas, black people, really get on my nerves. It's like there's this thing about wanting to take advantage of people just because they look like you or talk like you or they joke around a little bit. When it comes to me in business, I'm cool as Shani, but as Shani the businesswoman, the entrepreneur, I could be an asshole. The only reason why is because I've been burnt way too many times when I first started out. And mind you, I had my first business when I was 17 years old. It's been that long. And the reason why I do business consulting is because I teach people not to fail like I did.